If you've been feeling that Australians are paying prices that are too high too often, this guy agrees.
Australians are paying prices that are too high too often.
Former ACCC boss Alan Fells today releasing the damning findings of an ACTU inquiry into price gouging, calling out just about every sector.
Airfares, accommodation, entertainment, prepaid phone charges, credit cards, medical procedures.
All accused of using questionable practices to artificially drive up prices and, in doing so, drive up inflation.
Professor Fell's inquiry really shows that supermarkets, among many other sectors of the economy, really suffer from a lack of competition.
Some of the dodgy but common practices include excuseflation, where broader inflation provides a cover for businesses to raise prices without justification. Drip pricing, where one price is advertised, but extra fees and charges are slowly added during the purchase process. And rockets and feathers pricing, where costs rise quickly but fall slowly. Rocket and feathers pricing is the accusation being levelled at big supermarkets, with New South Wales farmers telling the inquiry,
supermarkets increase their prices straight away when there's a supply shortage or cost increase, but the opposite doesn't happen when there's, say, a large increase in supply.
Complaints against supermarkets dominating the inquiry, which also found evidence Aussie farmers are being screwed over by the power imbalance between them and the grocery giants, as well as evidence of fake discounting, where stores increase the price of an item so they can advertise it later as a special.
I feel scammed, to be honest, because it's not really a discount.
How does it make me feel? Well, a bit getting ripped off, I guess.
I just feel that a lot of retail stores do that. It's just not alone with grocery stores.
The COVID lockdown has really facilitated a rise in margins. They went up and they've not come back.
Coles hitting back, saying
the ACTU's union-led inquiry neglected to engage the supermarket sector or consider the many factors which affect supermarket pricing.
What we also would like to see, and not just from the government but also from things like the Reserve Bank, is greater pressure being put on companies, especially like Coles and Woolworths, to actually justify their prices, to justify their profit margins, because that in turn will put the pressure on them to compete more honestly.
So will this report be the catalyst to finally fix things for consumers and farmers?
Guy Gaeta is a fruit farmer who used to supply cherries and apples to Coles and Woolies, but stopped because he said it would have sent him broke. Guy, thanks for your time. Before we get into all that, I really mean it when I say thanks for joining us, because it's been really hard to get farmers to speak to us today. They just seem afraid to talk. Why do you think that is?
Because, and they got every reason not to say nothing, because they'll be crucified. They would reject their produce, finding some excuse that it's not up to their standards. They would stop buying their produce. And when we got the two major chains skied about they sell around 80% of the produce, well, there's nowhere else to go, really, is there?
Guy, how are the farmers in your area going?
There was 220 apple growers in Orange, all around our valley here. There is now 12. Now, if we were making such good money, why did all those people virtually go broke? And that's the thing. They'll tell you to believe everything. Yeah, they're not making any money. But, well, I haven't seen a Woolies or Coles store go broke yet and close down. Mm-hmm. If you know what I'm saying.
Of course.
Yeah, and you see, and the worst part about it, we're losing family farms. They are the most productive farmers. It's usually, like the word says, family farms. They grow good produce, they eat their own produce, and we just seem to be hell-bent on getting rid of them.
Now, Coles told us their profit margin is 2.6%, and then they reinvest that back into their stores. So what are your thoughts on that?
Well, I wish they would tell us what the farmer's profit margin is, but it's 2.6% of what? A million, 10 million, a billion? 10 billion. 2% is only a minute number, but that also can be a huge number. I was sent from the Grocery Association, which is probably owned by Coles and Woolworths. They told me that a year ago that Woolies only made $1.79 billion. That was just after COVID. $1.79 billion, you know? You know, that day I ran out of tissues, you know? If they're not making any money, why would people want to buy our shares? Look, I don't know. I'm only a farmer.
I love it.
Thanks for the chat. Really appreciate it.
Well, thank you for your time. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah. Need more people like Guy, yeah, right? Oh, we did reach out to both Coles and Woolies for their response to the inquiry, and their full statements can be found on our website.